We are really at early stages, but one of the things we are looking into is how can we synchronize traffic lights based on where are the pedestrians, how are they be crossing it, to time it better based on that as well. So these are also the research that we are working closely with CDOT. This is something that we have been working on for a few months, and now we actually get to share it with everyone so that others can see it. And this is really what we have been looking forward to, that we wanted to announce this so that everybody knows, the researchers and other at UTC and other universities, that we are basically here, that this is a test bed is here, and we are looking for collaboration.
Back in January, the version that you could see was a single camera, green dots. They would pick up and leave off every now and then, so the green dot would be centered on the vehicle. And it was really an ugly program. It didn't really work perfectly. But since then, I've had probably at least 40 days where I've been at home working on this remotely until 2 or 3 in the morning, trying to get this working. So since then, it's gone from just one camera to being able to parallelize it into 5 or 6 cameras in one computer. So we've been able to make this pretty much completely data-driven now. Adding new cameras is just a matter of changing a text file for a config file. I mean, it's easy enough that my 53-year-old mother could probably do it if I called her and actually walked her through it.
This is a real-world data, real-world problem. It's amazing to do a lot of work in the lab in front of your computers, but this is, you see actually how would it impact. Like, it's a meaningful project you're working on, and a lot of projects that, I mean, this one started with CDOT telling us about this, but many of them are the problems that actually community will tell us. This is what we are seeing as a challenge. So students really not only are getting trained, but also they can see that how their work is impacting their community.